If you are short on a budget, remove all the memorabilia. It actually relaxes us, more of a neutral theme. Like I said, less is more. Add some more accessories, some complementary color. Be assured that it will not going to clash.
Hey everyone, today we are making a special video of how to stage or decorate your home. And we have a special person here today, Samira Hassan with Samira Hassan Design. And she's going to walk us through how you can stage your home for sale or decorate your home that you just purchased. Or if you just want to decorate your home in general, she's going to give you some tips. Hi, Samira.
Hi everyone. I am Samira Hassan Design. Today, we're going to stage slash decorate this Ottoman coffee table slash bench. So for something that is a little bit on the soft side, a great idea to decorate is and accessorize is to put something stable like trays and books. So that way, when you are staging it, it's more stable and it won't be wobbly. For staging versus decorating, when you are staging, less is more. And when you are decorating, you have more room to show your personal style and your personal design preferences. For staging purposes, like I said, less is more, but there are certain design principles that work either way. For example, you have to have height, you have to have some complementary colors. Since this is brown, I'm going to put some complementary colors in there just to perk it up. Then I have a plant. For the book, we are going to add this rustic element, a little vase, some candles, little bit of the wood flower. So there you go. You have a staged, accessorized Ottoman bench. Now, if you don't like it or you prefer something else, you can always change it. Let your eye decide what your design preferences are. Let's say if we move this here and this, you prefer this, go ahead, do that. But if I kind of prefer this little bit of green and blue, and this is more of a neutral theme because we're going to keep it neutral and little bit of bling, some rustic element, little bit of flower, and then we have this brown and blue and greenery. You can't go wrong with greenery. One current trend in home design and staging is biophilia. And biophilia is where you add plants to your environment, and subconsciously it actually relaxes us when we see greenery around us. So if you are decorating with plants, it's always a plus in your home or in the staging environment. Jocelyn has asked me to talk about a little bit of color. So I'm going to talk about color as well. Your color is the biggest bang for your buck. So if you are short on a budget, you can always change the paint color and have a bigger impact as opposed to buying an expensive chair. So that will just be in one area, the chair. But if you have, like, let's say if you have limited budget, then color is something that can have a bigger impact on it. When choosing color, keep some things in mind. For example, the flooring and your furniture are worth your consideration before you go and pick your favorite colors. For staging, always go for neutral and what I call ecrufy it. Ecru is a kind of beige tone. And so if you have bright, bold colors, which I personally love, they are not very conducive to attracting buyers. So always, always go for neutral paint colors in your staging environment.
So would you consider these walls neutral?
I would, okay. It is a pale color. It is a non-confrontational color and it won't scare the buyers away.
Perfect. I do love those color choices that you put there, the blue and the green. Yeah. How does that complement this particular room?
So So if you see, this is the brown ottoman, and this is a neutral sofa and the neutral pillows. So neutral is like, it's always a good idea to put browns and grays with neutral. Green color, the shape of a plant or a vase, is always a good idea. It will always enhance the environment and never fight. But the choosing the blue here is because brown is in the red family and blue is the complementary color of red. If you are adding complementary color, you're sure that it will not going to clash. It will be a more pop of color. So if I was to add another color here, it may not pop that much, as opposed to like the blue, which is the opposite of brown. Because remember, brown is from the red family. If you add black to red, you get brown. If you add white to red, you get pink. So we noticed there are some pink pillows here. So that's also the same family from brown. So it goes well with this ottoman bench.
Now, let's talk about the difference between staging and decorating. Okay. So this example right here will be for staging, like, yes, a house that you are setting and you want it to look appealing to, right, every buyer.
Exactly.
How would that be different from decorating somebody who just bought a house?
So if we were decorating, we will go more and we will add some more bold accents. We will have this tray here, and then we'll have maybe like this, and then we'll add some more accessories for the book. So for the staging, you have to reduce where the international style of was, the international style is less is more. So in this case, you will reduce, you will take out and edit it. I did a course of staging course, and they said that you have to do subtraction, a lot of subtraction. Your closets need to be subtracted. Your accessories should be subtracted. Your furniture should be subtracted. You don't have to have 5 pieces of furniture because you don't want to overwhelm your clients.
Right.
And like, you know, in your closets, like, you know, go for the minimalistic look so that the clients think that their stuff will fit.
They can see themselves, yes, in the property instead of seeing you in, yes, in the, yeah.
And of course, one more tip that is super important is remove all the memorabilia. If you have like trophies or awards for the kids, the subconsciously we get we get this idea, oh my God, they'll be moving, they have this house here. You want to reduce all that emotion out of it. And you want them to envision the space as theirs.
You know what, Samira? I love you for saying that, because I have been saying that to my clients for 16 years, yes, and it's better coming from you than coming from me.
Yes. I am like a neutral person because you have an environment. And that this is where, like, you know, they need to hear it from someone else's lips.
Right. Because especially a professional like, yes, you, who does this for a living.
Yes.
And so that's why I appreciate you very much for sharing that with me today. And please tell people how they can contact you if they want to get their home staged or decorated.
Right. So thank you for asking. My company's name is Samira Hassan Design. They can find me on Google at www.samirahassandesign or on Facebook at Samira Hassan Design. They can also text me. My phone number is 321-987-0366. They are welcome to contact you and, yeah, ask my contact information through you. And they can find me on Instagram too at Design Edict. Facebook and
Instagram and
because I have a Facebook group on there as Home Decor for Trendy Mom, where I put a lot of design advice and tips and color trends. So they can join.
Did you guys hear that? Home Design for Trendy Mom.
Yes, Home Decor for Trendy Mom.
Oh, Home Decor for, yeah, trendy Mom. So everybody, we'll be putting Samira Hassan's contact information below, in the contact below. So if you want to get a hold of her, contact us below. My information will be there as well. We are looking forward to working with you, and Samira is ready to start decorating your home. Thank you so much for watching.
Thank
See you, everybody. See you next time.